So there are four major parts of the polygraph machine. These four major parts are cardiospemograph, the second is pneumograph, the third one is galvanograph, and the last one is chemograph. So we'll be discussing the various individuals who contributed on the development of these major parts of the polygraph machine. So we will start with the development of cardiospemograph. The first person is Angelo Mosso. He studied fear and its influence on the heart. He developed the sphygmomanometer and scientific cradle, which was designed to measure the flow of blood while a person lay on his back in a prone position. The second one is the father of criminology, Dr. Cesar Lambroso. He employed the first instrument that measures changes in pulse and blood pressure when the suspects were asked about their involvement in certain cases. Lambroso was accorded as the first person who first utilized an instrument in the detection of lies. The next one is William Moulton Marston. He is considered as the father of modern polygraphy. He dealt with a sphygmomanometer and made researches on its use in the detection of lies. So Cesar Lambroso is known today as the father of modern criminology. In the field of criminology, cadets, we have a lot of people whom we call as fathers according to their own specialization. Like in the case of modern criminology, we hail Cesar Lambroso as our father of modern criminology. We also have a father of police photography. We also have father of modern law enforcement, specifically Sir Robert Peel. We also have father of modern polygraphy, which is William Moulton Marston. So the contribution of Marston was mainly on his researches as to the detection of lies. We also have John Larson. John Larson developed instrument that continually and simultaneously measures blood pressure and pulse and respiration. Leonard Keeler, who invented the Keeler polygraph, which was an improvement of Larson's apparatus. He also devised metal bellows and designed a chemograph that pulled a constant speed a chart paper under the recording pens from a roll of chart paper located inside the instrument. In the later slides, we will be discussing the function of the cardiospemograph, the function of the pneumograph, the function of the galvanograph, and the last one is the function of the chemograph. So in this case, the person who invented the chemograph, which is part of the polygraph machine, which has the responsibility to pull at constant speed the polygraph or the chart paper, is no other than the chemograph. So the person who invented the chemograph was no other than Leonard Keeler. At the same time, he introduced what we call as the Keeler polygraph machine, which was an improvement of Larson's apparatus. As to the development of pneumograph, we have Vittorio Binosi. Vittorio Binosi was the one who detected deception with pneumograph, an instrument that graphically measures inhalation and exhalation, because pneumograph is a major component of polygraph machine, which actually measures the respiration of the individual and try to correlate this respiration to deception. So si Vittorio Binosi, he was one of the persons who detected deception by means of the pneumograph. The next one is Harold Bird. He determined that respiratory changes were indications of deception. He found out that changes in systolic blood pressure were of greater value in determining deception than changes in respiration. So si Harold Bird was focusing mainly on blood pressure. So according to him, it is more reliable to measure blood pressure in correlation to deception other than deception in correlating it with respiration. So he's trying to emphasize that it is more reliable to record pressure and correlate it to deception rather than recording respiration to correlate it with deception. As to the development of galvanograph, we have Luigi Galvani. He was the person who developed the galvanic skin reflex, or we call it today as galvanometer. The galvanometer, which recorded electrical bodily resistance in terms of ohms. Take note, ohms is the lowest current ever recorded. The GSR, or the galvanometer, or galvanic skin reflex, reflected emotional changes by measuring in the person's skin resistance to a very small current of electricity. Next person is Vera Goth. He was the first person who first used the term psychogalvanic reflex. He believed that the electrical phenomenon is due to the activity of the sweat glands. So, ang galvanograph, siya mo yung measure sa skin resistance to ohms, to a small current of electricity, which is ohms. So, if a person will tell a lie, or a person will not tell the truth, according to Galvani and Viragot, there will be a sudden, or there will be changes to the activity of the sweat glands when a person will tell deception. Now, since polygraph examination involves questioning technique, let us also examine those different individuals who developed the different questioning techniques. The first one is Keeler, or Leonard Keeler. He was the person who developed the relevant and irrelevant technique. Take note again that it was Keeler who also developed or improved Larson's apparatus, and he termed it as Keeler polygraph. He was also the person who introduced the chemograph as one of the major components of a polygraph machine. So aside from this contribution, he also developed the so-called relevant and irrelevant test. The exhaustive discussion of relevant and irrelevant technique will be done on the later topics. The theory of this test is that guilty reacts only to relevant questions and innocent shows no reactions. It is also credited with introducing the card test and the specialized in peak of tension test. So we will be discussing in the next topics what is relevant and irrelevant test, what is card number test, and what is peak of tension test. These three various tests were introduced by no other than Leonard Keeler. We also have John Reed. John Reed was the person who developed the so-called reviewed or controlled questions, consisting of a known lie incorporated into relevant and irrelevant test. He also discovered the guilt complex test administered to overlay responsive subject. These are the contributions by John Reed. As to Clive Baxter, in 1960, he conceived the psychological set theory that provides constant monitoring of the subject's reactivity and designed to disclose outside issue. He was the person who developed the so-called Baxter zone comparison test. On the other hand, other pioneers in the field of deception detection are the following. The first one is the one who invented or developed the word association test, Francis Galton. We also have Alan Bell. He's an American inventor who developed a device called PSE, or the Psychological Stress Evaluator. This is an instrument which will detect slight trembling in the voice, which may be interpreted to determine if a person is telling the truth. Anton Mesmer, in 1778, the first one to introduce hypnotism as a method of detecting deception. By the way, guys, as I have mentioned in the previous discussion, hypnotism, truth serum, whatever confession that are obtained from these methodologies of investigation shall not be used as evidence in the court simply because this devoid a person from his entire volition. When I say volition, I'm referring to the voluntariness to give or to confess on something. So if they confess because they are subjected to hypnotism or truth serum, such confessions shall be considered as a fruit of the poisonous tree. So it shall not be considered as evidence in the court. So we have various types of lies. The first type of lie is what we call as direct denial. So in direct denial, meaning the person directly denied the accusation. An example of this one is, I did not do it. So this statement signifies a direct denial to a particular accusation. On the other hand, lie of omission. The lie of omission is basically telling the truth, but what you do is that in the process of telling the truth, what you do is you omit some of its details, okay? And omitting some of its details is something that could create possible troubles. So lie of omission is not entirely a lie. It is half lie, at the same time, half truth. Half lie or half truth meaning you tell the truth, but you omit some of its details. The next one is lie of fabrication. When we say lie of fabrication, this is the most difficult lie that subject could use in an interview. This is done by inventing stories or details that are far behind from the truth. Let us say you claim that you are a graduate of a doctorate degree, where in fact you are just an undergrad. So that is an example of lie of fabrication. You lie that you were absent from the crime scene. That is also a lie of fabrication. Or you lied that you did not stab someone, where in fact, in reality, you are the person who perpetrated the crime. That is an example of lie of fabrication. When you say fabrication, from the word fabricate, meaning you tend to invent something. You invent stories and details in order to conceal the truth. Next is lie of minimization. In this type of lie, the individual will accept but downplays the implication. It could be used if a subject wanted to stay close to the truth, however, he covers a portion of the truth for his or her own benefit. So lie of minimization, meaning you just downplays the implication, you just downplays a particular criminal act. Say for example, you intentionally punch a person, but you downplay the act of punching as if it was just accidental. But in reality, it was intentional. So such kind of lie is lie of minimization. The next one is lie of exaggeration. This is a lie used to exaggerate things for the hope of obtaining some advantage. Or this is usually a type of lie given by those persons who are blabbers, those individuals who are hubris, or those persons who have high confidence within themselves. So lie of exaggeration. Ang white lie is also known as benign lie. This is a lie used to maintain harmony of friendship of the home or office. So a white lie is something that is given simply because it is something that would establish harmonious relationship to anybody. Like say for example, somebody asks you, do I look beautiful in my outfit? So you tell a lie, yung kanito nga, that outfit suits you well. So benign lie. Next one is red lie. This is a lie used to destroy other ideologies by means of propaganda, like the propaganda by the rebel groups in the Philippines. Example is just a red lie. Malicious lie, a chronic lie, purely used to mislead justice. A pure dishonesty to obstruct justice. An example of malicious lies such as perjury, forgery, anything, or false entry on a document. So these are examples of malicious lie. Something that would obstruct or something that would mislead justice. So what does the polygraph records? Kung saan may pwede nga ma-record sa polygraph machine? By the way guys, I have to repeat this again. When I say polygraph, I am referring to the lie detector machine. When I say polygraphy means the science of detection of deception. So, this is a polygraph. This is a machine that will record something, or that will record the changes of the blood pressure, the pulse rate, the galvanic skin reflex. So, kaning tulo, the three will be recorded by the polygraph machine. I repeat, these are blood pressure, the pulse rate, and the galvanic skin reflex. It does not matter if the subject is nervous during the testing process, because that is to be expected. A person intending to be deceptive to a particular question will activate his what we call a sympathetic nervous system, or the SNS, as a self-defense mechanism when that question is asked on the test. So basically, when a person will lie, the SNS will be activated. And that activation of the SNS is something that will signal, upon looking at the tracing, something that would signal that a person is lying on a particular question. For us to understand more on what does the polygraph records, let us define the following terms. First is response. This refers to any activity of an organism or as effect, organ, or part of the organism resulting from simulation. Specific response is any deviation from the normal tracing of a subject. So if you take a look on the polygram or the polygraph chart containing the tracings, you can see two types of tracings, the normal tracings and the specific response form of tracings. The specific response would signify the deviation from the normal tracing. When we say deviation, something that is unique from the normal tracing, something that is different from the normal tracing. So tawag ana is specific response. Normal response, on the other hand, is those tracing in the polygraph chart consisting of norms. When you say norms, normally siya nga responses considering harmonic mga tubag sa irrelevant questions. Okay? Maunig mga answers sa irrelevant questions. So, normal response meaning there is no deviation from the tracing. Next, polygraph examiner is the one who conducts or administer the test. The chart of the polygrams refers to the composite records of the pneumograph, the galvanograph, and the cardiospirograph tracings recorded from series of questions. The subject, on the other hand, refers to a person being examined. Now, let us go now to the kinds of polygraph machine. First, we will talk about the analog polygraph instrument. So, these are the models of the analog polygraph instrument that we have right now. So we have first B and W lie detector model 8AC. During the early 1950s, B and W Associates of Michigan City, Indiana manufactured this type of instrument. The only function is to measure the GSR activity. When we say GSR again, we're referring to the galvanic skin reflex of a person. So this type of machine only records one tracing, and that is the tracing from the GSR or from the galvanic skin reflex. The next one is the Killer Polygraph Model 6317, manufactured by the Associated Research Company of Chicago, Illinois. During the Korean War, this instrument was utilized by the CIA and again in the early 1960s to polygraph Cuban nationals to determine if they were spies. We also have another version or another model of the Killer Polygraph, which is 6338. It was introduced as a four-channel instrument which recorded simultaneously changes in the blood pressure, the heart rate, the pulse wave amplitude, blood volume, oxygenation of the blood, respiration, and electrical skin resistance. Another version of the Killer Polygraph is this model 6308. This was used initially in military operations. Is one of the first instruments that can easily be changed from a desk mount to a portable unit without tools. Another model of Killer Polygraph is 302. The chart drive unit that is powered by a synchronous motor at speeds of either 6 or 12 inches per minute. There are four recording pens. The lower pen and its associated control comprise the pulse blood pressure unit, while the longer pen records electrothermal variations. We also have the Lafayette Electrocardiopolygraph Model 76056. This was considered to be the most popular instrument introduced at the time, with double pneumographs, galvanic skin reflex, electrocardio, and a top-mounted pneumatic stimulus marker. Lee and Sons Berkeley Psychograph, otherwise known as a Lee Polygraph, this instrument was designed to be a compact, portable unit that encompasses a novel arrangement of rubber. The next one is the Stolte Model 22600 Emotional Stress Monitor. This model is a three-pen instrument. Later, it has four parts already until present time it is being used. We also have Stolte Cardiopneumopolygraph. It was considered to be very sensitive for its time, but only operated on a two-pin inking system recording pneumo and cardio tracings. So, duha lang yung record ang pneumo o cardio tracings lang sa Stolte Cardiopneumopolygraph. On the other model, we have Stolte Dissipograph Model 22500. This model contained vacuum tubes in its amplifier that required approximately 30 minutes of warm-up time before use. As to a computer polygraph system, we have the LX4000. This combines conventional polygraph procedure with sophisticated state-of-the-art computer. Results are divided from the following traditional physiological parameters: pneumo, total respiration input channels, the GSR, the galvanic skin response reflex, or the last one, the cardio blood volume or pulse rate. So muna yung pinaka-latest ang computer polygraph, the LX4000. So those are the discussions that are covered under this episode. If you have questions, below this video you can see a comment section. You can write in or you can post your comments, and by the time I take a look at that comments, I will provide you with answers. Thank you so much for watching.